picture rather than to the third dimension. So he lifts the withers up, as hollow as your rib cage. Okay, you can work the half fold on your outside rein and push through with your left leg. Half fold, left leg, inside leg on, not too small. Because as you say, he does it to the end, then he suddenly rotates his belly and runs out. Hmm. It's the same problem you're having in the half plank, where he drops his belly down, he runs away from it a little bit. Especially when you change between the leg yield and the half pass. So just for you, as a rider, take care of that a little bit more. Don't be, that's right, half fold. So think of the belly staying up as you come out of the exercise. Meaning he stays hollow from your inside leg upwards to the withers into your left rein. That was better. Okay, so you just take a little more care there. Because he's so wiggly and quick, you just it's very easy for him to change his weight and his position of his body. It's not, this is not success necessarily going in the right place or doing a good thing, but he does it. So he's sort of in that sense quite unstable, but he's so mobile when he goes in all directions, but it's harder to keep him organized. He has to be very careful that he's really organizing coming out of anything lateral. So the combined connection. Okay, so try a little canter. Again, so don't somehow just try to get into the canter. Wave a little bit, organize the canter or the walk until you're getting into the canter so you get a quick transition. Okay, now working on really good rhythm in the canter. And really concentrate to keep your shoulders relaxed and down, Katie. That you all, you know, keeping your center of gravity as low as possible. And then he doesn't sort of, it's like almost like you're pulling spaghetti out of the pot.
Problem. That's why I put a double in, because I had never any contact, so I'm trotting around, I'm just pretending, because he can lift your head up and look at wherever he wants. So he was very always light, so I tried to do the double a bit more into it, but I couldn't be more connection, but still not connecting from there. I can't feel it, because if I do it, he would be really overbent when I can feel the connection.
Yeah. No, you've got it all figured out. It's all right.
But I didn't know how else to do it.
Try and do this with your reins. You're shaking somebody's hand, and get the rein up at the top. Okay, and then just take the curved rein just like you would normally. Okay, so that can go there. That's it. Okay, so you've got a little, you know, more pressure on the sample.
I had that as well.
Try to think of the reins being like rope, like bamboo sticks.
Push them out.
Yeah, so yeah. You're pushing out. So you have the feeling that you drop your shoulders down. Drop your weight down through here, and then at that moment,
push him up. Yeah.
That idea of pushing him through the withers a little bit more. Okay? So your hands quiet, and then really concentrate that he hooks up. The more you can ride in rhythm, the more he can relax and do what he wants. So the more you can hook him up and do your pushing, the more he'll stay with you.
Mm.
Okay? Rather than just pushing 400 kilos with meat, think of really concentrating on what the legs are doing and trying to feel that rhythm of the canter.
Yeah.
Okay? And then into this. If you get some pressure, if possible, the mouth, so that you, with this feeling, that you're coming from your elbows through to your fingers, and you're lifting in this way,
yeah.
And when you push, you do this. Yeah, so you're having this thing happening?
Yeah, you go push. At the same time, it also
goes. So try to get a little more positive pressure here, relax here, come more through this part of the neck.
Yeah.
Okay, it's wired between your hands, and then he opens up
the
here. Okay, so that you try to have that feeling, that thought in your mind. Okay, try that. Okay, don't be afraid to have them quite short. So don't think because the reins are short, the neck's going to get short. Okay, because it's all about trying to hook up pressures. That's better. Okay, so and especially in the corners, especially when you put any pressure to turn, you must turn upwards and not downwards. And then always out of your leg, feeling on the next counter strike, go up and out. When he lands, that's what you should already have, when he's lifting up, when you want to push. You don't want to push when he's in the ground. Okay, so the same thing, looking up from your leg, always that upwards movement, the outside front leg comes off the ground to your contact. Again, lift through the feeling of your wrists, your if you're pushing your thumbs up towards your nose. There you go. Again. There you go. You feel that? Can you feel that? Shoulders down. So you're not pulling your hands up with your shoulders. So you're keeping your core down very heavy. That's it. There you go. Got it? Okay, a little bit outside contact. Don't get the reins longer and longer. You put those like slides behind, because if the reins are too long, you put your reins up, your hands like this, he'll drop behind you. You must keep a relatively short rein and always keep shoving the energy up to where your hands are taking the nose out. That's it. And then again, don't flex him to the inside where you're going to change. Try to keep his neck really straight and change his leg. And concentrate again a little more half ball. So you better bring him back up in front of you. Watch you not get into backwards moment. Okay, bring your hands a little bit more together. Okay, so think of always pressing him together and you've got almost like a bridge over the neck. Okay, and then constantly, it doesn't matter if he wiggles or jiggles, you constantly push past the bridge. Ignore it. Don't try to fix them by moving. That's right. Okay, so try to adjust pressure problems with your leg. Okay, and then move them up and just flipping the nose up and out.
Yeah.
There you go. Leave him there. Push on with your leg. Look up from behind. Look up from behind. Leave his neck there. Don't be afraid of him being a little bit too high for a moment. If he gets a bit stuck, then flex him one slightly to the outside. Okay, so go in the circle. Okay, and then decrease your circle with a little bit of outside flexion. So regulate him off your outside leg and make sure his head's staying up. So you're hitting the moment of the jump and the canter up through both ears, both legs. Good. So he's lifting his left shoulder up. So push it up and decrease your circle. Okay, concentrate that the rhythm comes up through both ears. That's right. Turn smaller. Up, both legs. Okay, so pressure. Don't just hold him with your leg. Give a pressure that he's jumping off the ground. You want to enhance the canter. Okay, small circle still. And the leg yield concept. Don't change the neck just because you've got half of him with your leg. Okay, smaller the circle. Move his shoulders to the left. Touch with the whip on the shoulder. Yep, his head stays there. Leave him there. And the transition to walk. Okay, leave him there. Leave him there. Keep your contact. Outside shoulder, a little bit of outside flexion, move the withers to the left. That's right. Even if you think, oh man, he feels like a moose, don't worry about it. And canter again. Canter. Without any flexion, good. Push on, really solid feeling pressure forward from the back end over the withers into the contact. The other feeling starts to pull maybe a little bit, which will be good. Pull forward, not downwards, right? That's it. Push. Decrease your circle again. Both legs. Hey, don't give your reins away. He won't go forward. Push him into that contact. Insist that he stays there in the neck. Give him a little touch on the right hind leg. Good. That's right. And once more, in the rhythm. Feel the rhythm of the canter and give him a little touch with the stick that he jumps up forward to your contact. And walk. Good. Push through, half halt. Control the right side. And canter once more. Good. Push on, next canter stride. Good, Katie, that's the idea. Okay, so keeping the same feeling, you're going to change rein through the half diagonal with a good flying change. Okay, you're not going to fiddle with him or do anything. You're just going to push him through here onto this, like get him onto your left rein. Okay, so come out of your circle. And you're going to come across the half diagonal. Come, you can't come moving across the half diagonal. Nope. So half diagonals would be to E, to B rather.
I'm really sorry, I can't hear at all. It's going every, I can hear every beginning of your word. I can't hear. It's
interrupting all the time. I can only hear when you say walk.
Oh.
It's maybe the
wonder why.